This is Her Last Wish, a Rachel Gift Mystery Series, Book 1, written by Blake Pierce, narrated by Mary Sarah. Chapter 1. It was one of the rare days that Rachel was actually pleased with the woman she saw staring back at her in the mirror. She looked closer to 25 than her actual age of 33, and she was having a good hair day. She'd slept soundly last night, and her brown eyes had a well-rested sparkle. Even her skin was on point today, glowing slightly under the bathroom lights. Not that it mattered. She had training today, and in about 3 hours, she'd be sweating and her hair would be in a ponytail. She enjoyed the training, though, and would gladly look like a sweating ragged mess if it meant she'd had a good session. She smiled at the anticipation of it, despite the awful singing voice coming from the shower behind her. The voice of her husband, Peter, belting out, "Head over heels, by tears for fears." "Darling," she said with a smile, "I love you dearly, but you missed that note by about a trillion octaves." Peter responded by increasing his volume and reaching for a high note that wasn't even a part of the song.
"You know,"
he said, following the note,
"most women would appreciate being serenaded before they go off to work."
"This is more like the torture technique the army used in Afghanistan by pumping Marilyn Manson into prisons at 3 in the morning.
"Sweet, let your supervisors know. Maybe I'd make a fine addition at the FBI. Then you could work around the singing voice all day long."
Before she could respond, Peter started singing again. When Rachel left the bathroom, there was a huge smile on her face. It was just one of those days. One of those days where even before the morning had gotten a good start, you just knew it was going to be a good day. Despite the awful off-key chorus, she was actually glad to hear Peter singing in the shower. It was something he'd been doing a lot more as of late. They'd been working at having a second child for the past few weeks, which meant a much more active sex life. Their first daughter, a daughter Paige, had come after some difficulty, and they were hoping the second would be a bit easier. She knew Peter didn't mind putting in the time trying to get her pregnant, but Rachel rather hoped it would happen soon. When Rachel got downstairs, Paige was already awake. She was standing in front of the refrigerator on her tiptoes as she tried to get the orange juice. She dressed herself, which Rachel always encouraged, and none of it matched. She was wearing a black Descendants shirt with a pair of striped leggings that were green and white in color. Her brown hair was still up in the pigtails Rachel had put in place the day before. "Hey there, Squirt," Rachel said, stepping in behind her daughter and getting the orange juice down for her.
"Good morning, Mummy," Paige said. "Glad to see you're already dressed for the day. You got big plans for the day?"
"No,
just school,"
Paige said, though there was excitement in her voice. Paige seemed to love everything about kindergarten, which was good. She was just like her mother in that she did not particularly take instruction well. It was a trait that seemed to dissolve the moment Paige stepped into a classroom, though. Her teacher had nothing but remarkable things to say about Paige, something Rachel tried not to take too much pride in.
"What about this weekend?" Rachel asked, taking the glass of orange juice to the table, where Paige was sitting with a bowl of applejacks she'd apparently already poured for herself.
Rachel cringed internally at the thought of drinking orange juice with applejacks. "Anything big you'd like to do?"
"Mrs. Denning said I could come ride one of her horses, remember?"
"Yes, but I..."
"And Annie Jenkins is having an ice cream party. Oh, and I want to try that new jump park all the kids in my class are talking about."
Rachel smiled. Her daughter always had huge plans. The girl hated to sit still. Another trait she got directly from Rachel.
"That does sound like a busy weekend."
Rachel set about making a smoothie while preparing a bowl of oatmeal. Because she had training this morning, she'd probably also eat a protein bar on the way to the obstacle course.
She fully expected to be drained and maybe even flushed with adrenaline by the end of it. So protein was going to be key. She sat down at the table with Paige, enjoying the fact that she didn't need to rush this morning. Her training day started a little later than a typical day.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.